What would you say in terms of growth was the biggest driver for the reporting period?
First, the market might have been a little surprised. We do exceptionally well in the UK and in France. So the second quarter, we had a steady growth, a little below 5% organically, above 6 including acquisition. And that was in line with our full year guidance. But what probably will be noticed is another progression of our operating margin, since we grew our margin by 50 basis points, which allowed us to increase our net earning by 23%.
What are the expectations you have as far as Brexit goes? You know, we're going into talks or maybe refusal to talk. The uncertainty is high, as our guest on set, Jose Luis Jimenez, has told us. How is the outlook for you in terms of Brexit or UK business?
First, we, as a company, we do not do UK versus EU any trade. So the production of software in the UK is based either locally or with India. So we will not be directly impacted by the Brexit. There will be indirect consequences, but no direct. So for a few quarters, we have refocused our business in the UK. First, some public sector, including our big account with Majesty Revenues and Customs, and a good progression in the world of energy and utilities, which should be safe. We have noticed that the retail segments and the consumer goods segment are somewhat soft, some apprehension about consumer behavior.
We hear from an analyst, Nicholas David, writes from Odo that your infrastructure services was a big part of the growth here because of the end of the transformation process. How does that look then going forward, Paul?
So clearly, the cloud disruption has impacted massively what we used to call managed service, so multi-year contract of infra outsourcing. Now we have completed the migration to the new cloud environment, so we help our client to drive their cost reduction and flexibility of their infra. So for us, it's a good news. Our infra service has now stabilized and starts growing.
So now you want to start growing. You've made the Altran acquisition. Do you have any other companies in your sights?
No, first, Altran will be a significant move. Huh? Historically, we have been doing year after year. We allocated half of our free cash flow generation to small acquisition bolt-ons. Altran is something different because you mentioned the equity value, but we take the debt of Altran, so it is a move that represents more than 5 billion euro. So we will have to digest that, to develop that into new offerings. We are certainly focused on what we call the convergence between IT and operational technology in the world of intelligent industry. In a couple of years, we will look beyond that, but we will be focused on that in the next 2 years.
Can I ask how the low interest rate environment is affecting your business, Paul, or the business of those that are your clients?
I would say we have noticed this quarter, for the first time, the group has moved so that what we call digital and cloud has now exceeded 50% of the group revenue. This fuels further our growth because there are mission critical technology projects that will fuel our growth. I wouldn't say whatever the economical environment, but it's vital for company to invest in digital. This is why we are optimistic for the remainder of the year.
Let me finally ask you, as Lighthizer and his U.S. counterparts head to Shanghai for talks with the Chinese, everyone's hopeful, I'm sure, for a positive outcome, but how has the trade war affected your business thus far?
As we all see, the biggest segment, the one that has been impacted, is the automotive segment. The slowdown in China, the threat of potential taxation over U.S. imports. So we have noticed a slowdown in automotive in the first half. There are still some good prospects of investment in automotive, but that was the segment on which we are the most vigilant.